Interpreter, O Holy Trinity, have mercy upon us. O God, the Lord of hosts, be with us, for in our hardships and tribulations we have no helper but you. O God, absolve, forgive, and remit our transgressions, which we committed intentionally, unintentionally, knowingly, unknowingly, secretly, and openly. Lord, forgive us for the sake of your holy name, which is bestowed upon us. Yes, according to your mercies, O Lord, and not according to our sins. Be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, and deliver us from evil. Through Christ Jesus our Lord, who is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Tayo o tayo nemo ao ente panagia trias viot nemi pshirinem piem namasuab o herininem o kote gente o imavatsuab en kasolikin apostolikin keklese ente evnoti amin ariev me vepshoi se ne etav inina ke khonen naidoro nemni etav inu ega o nemni etav inu evol hetoto My not irum biviki be evol chinni fi owi.
Joy.
Ελευράν, εμιβιώτ νέου σύριν πιεύνο μασού αφενότιν ότιος μάρωτ, εν γεύνο τη βιώτ πι πάντο κράτορ. Εφες μάρωτ, εν γεύπευ μογονείς, εν σύρι Ιησός βαχρέστος βεν σόις. Εφες μάρωτ, εν γεύπευ νευμασού αφεν παρακλή. Ετών. Marin tiorofopoth entev aria eron, chempais o avvainim neotiron tepen on chenherin in even, enge pipanto krato or, epshoi sepenoti. Σοίσευ νότι πι πάντο κράτορ. Εβιώτεμ μπεν σοίσο αχ μπεν νότι αουα μπεν σωτήρ εσός. Μπι έχερ εστός. We thank you for everything, concerning everything and in everything. For you have covered us, helped us, guarded us, accepted us to yourself, spared us, supported us, and have brought us to this hour.
Lord, have mercy.
Therefore, we ask and entreat your goodness, O lover of mankind, grant us complete this holy day and all the days of our life. In all peace with you, all fear, all envy, all temptation, all the work of Satan, the counsel of wicked men and the rising up of enemies hidden and manifest, take them away from us and from all your people, And from this holy table, and from this holy church, and from this holy place that is yours. Nezihes na nev nemniet en rov sahniem maunen. Jen sok bet katim bershishina nehom yezhen nehov. Nemniet shili nem ezhen tigom teres en tebigaji.
This day, my father, the priest, the deacon, the clergy, and all the people, and my weakness be absolved from the mouth of the whole Holy Trinity, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and from the mouth of the one Holy Catholic and Apostolic Church, and from the mouth of the 12 apostles, and from the mouth of the beholder of God, the evangelist Mark, the holy apostle and martyr, the patriarchs and Severus, our teacher, Dioscorus and Athanasius, the apostolic Saint Peter, the holy martyr and high priest, Saint John Chrysostom, Saint Cyril, Saint Basil, and Saint Gregory. And from the mouth of the 318 assembled at Nicaea, and the 150 at Constantinople, and the 200 at Ephesus. And from the mouth of our honored father, the high priest, Pope Abba Tawadros II. And from the mouth of his partner in the liturgy, our honored father, the Bishop Amba Serapion. And from my own mouth, being the least, for blessed and full of glory is your holy name, O Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and forever, unto the ages of all ages. Amen.
Amen. Paul, the servant of our Lord Jesus Christ, called to be an apostle appointed to the gospel of God. A chapter from the first epistle of our teacher, St. Paul, to the Corinthians, may his blessings be upon us. Amen. Let a man so consider us as servants of Christ and stewards of the mysteries of God. Moreover, it is required in stewards that one be found faithful. But with me, it is a very small thing that I should be judged by you or by a human court. In fact, I do not even judge myself, for I know nothing against myself, yet I am not justified by this. But he who judges me is the Lord. Therefore, judge nothing but the time until the Lord comes, who will both bring to light of the hidden things of darkness and reveal the counsels of the heart. And then each one's praise will come from God. Now these things, brethren, I have figuratively transferred myself and Apollos for your sake, that you may learn in us not to think beyond what is written, that none of you may be puffed up on behalf of one against the other. For who makes you differ from another? And what do you have that you did not receive? Now if you indeed receive it, why do you glory as if you have not received it? You are already full. You are already rich. You have reigned as kings without us. And indeed, I could wish you did not reign, that we also might reign with you. For I think that God has displayed us, the apostles, last as men condemned to death. For we have been made a spectacle to the world, both to angels and to men. We are fools for Christ's sake, but you are wise in Christ. We are weak, but you are strong. You are distinguished, but we are dishonored. Even to the present hour, we both hunger and thirst, and we are poorly clothed and beaten and homeless, and we labor working with our own hands. Being reviled, we bless. Being persecuted, we endure it. Being defamed, we entreat. We have been made as the filth of the world, the offscouring of all things until now. I do not write these things to shame you, but as my beloved children, I warn you. For though you might have 10,000 instructors in Christ, yet you do not have many fathers, for in Christ Jesus I have begotten you through the gospel. Therefore I urge you, imitate me. The grace of God the Father be with you all. Amen.
Catholic epistle from the second epistle of our teacher St. Peter. May his blessings be with us all. Amen. My beloved, we also have the prophetic word made more sure, which you do well to heed as a light that shines in a dark place, until the day dawns and the morning star rises in your hearts. Knowing this first, that no prophecy of Scripture is of any private interpretation, for prophecy never came by the will of man, but holy men of God spoke as they were moved by the Holy Spirit. But there were also false prophets among the people, even as there will be false teachers among you, who will secretly bring in destructive heresies, even denying the Lord who bought them, and bring on themselves swift destruction. And many will follow their destructive ways, because of whom the way of the truth will be blasphemed. By covetousness, they will exploit you with deceptive words. For a long time their judgment has not been idle, and their destruction does not slumber. For if God did not spare the angels who sinned, but cast them down to hell and deliver them into chains of darkness to be reserved for judgment, and did not spare the ancient world, but save Noah, one of eight people, a preacher of righteousness, bringing in the flood of the world of the ungodly, and turning the cities of Sodom and Gomorrah into ashes, and then them to destruction, making them an example to those afterward who would live ungodly, and delivered righteous Lot, who was oppressed with the filthy conduct of the wicked. For that righteous man dwelling among them tormented his righteous soul from day to day by seeing and hearing their lawless deeds. Then the Lord, who knows how to deliver the godly out of temptations and to reserve the unjust under punishment for the day of judgment. Do not love the world or the things which are in the world. The world shall pass away and all his desires, but he who does the will of God shall abide forever. Amen.
Yeah. Acts of our fathers, apostles, may their holy blessings be with us all. Amen. Now when they had passed through Amphipolis and Apollonia, they came to the Thessalonica, where there was a synagogue of the Jews. Then Paul, as his custom was, went into them, and for the three Sabbaths reasoned with them from the Scriptures, explaining and demonstrating that the Christ had to suffer and rise again from the dead, and saying, "This Jesus whom I preach to you is the Christ." And some of them were persuaded, and a great multitude of the devout Greeks and not a few of the leading women joined Paul and Silas. But the Jews who were not persuaded became envious, took some of the evil men from the marketplace, and gathering a mob, set all the city in an uproar and attacked the house of Jason and sought to bring them out to the people. Now when they did not find them, they dragged Jason and some brethren to the rulers of the city, crying out, "These who have turned the world upside down have come here too. Jason has harbored them, and these are all acting contrary to the decrees of Caesar, saying there is another king, Jesus." And they troubled the crowd and the rulers of the city when they heard these things. So when they had taken security from Jason and the rest, they let them go. Then the brethren immediately sent Paul and Silas away by night to Berea. When they arrived, they went into the synagogue of the Jews. These were more fair-minded than those in Thessalonica, and that they received the word with all readiness, and searched the Scriptures daily to find out whether these things were so. Therefore many of them believed, and also not a few of the Greeks, prominent women as well as men. The word of the Lord shall grow, multiply, be mighty, be confirmed in the Holy Church of God. Amen.
Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, one God. Amen. Today is the 15th day of the blessed month of Ba'una. May God begin it in goodness and renew it for us in peace and tranquility, while our sins and iniquities are forgiven through the tender mercies of my Father, O my fathers and my brethren. Amen. On this day, the Church celebrates the commemoration of the consecration of the Church of the great Mary Mina al-Agaibi, or the Miraculous, in Meriut, in Egypt. The Lord wanted to reveal the location of the relics of the saint. So there was a shepherd in that place who used to have a scabby sheep. A sheep fell into the stream of water, came out, rolled on the sand of that place, and was cured at once. The shepherd was astonished, and he started taking sand from that place, mixing it with water, and rubbing all the sheep that suffered from the scabies or any kind of defects, and they were all cured at once. That matter spread all over the region till it reached to the Emperor of Constantinople, whose only daughter was suffering from leprosy. The emperor sent his daughter to that place, where she took some sand, mixed it with water, and rubbed it on her body. That night she slept in the same place and saw a vision of Saint Mina saying to her, "Wake up early and dig in that place. You will find my relics." When she woke up the next morning, she found herself cured. She dug in that place and found the relics of the saint. She sent to her father and told him what had happened. He rejoiced and sent money to build a church in that place. The church was consecrated on this day, and the relics were put into that church. When Arcadius Vonerus became king, he built a city in that place named Meriut. The people used to seek the intercession of Saint Mina, and God performed many miracles through him. The church of Saint Mina was demolished when the Arabs invaded Egypt. But many other churches were built in his name, like the ones of that in Saint Athanasius the Apostolic had built in the name of the saint. Then Pope Theophilus, the Patriarch, the 23rd on the Sea of St. Mark, built a larger church near the older one that extended towards the east. He also built a monastery in the saint's name in Fum al-Khalig in Cairo. Finally, Pope Carolus VI, the 116th on the Sea of St. Mark, rebuilt the monastery of Mary Mina at Meriut, where he placed the relics of the saint in a great celebration that was held on the 15th of Ba'una in the year of 1675 of the martyrs, or 1959 AD. attended by the bishops, the priests, and the people. May the blessings of the great Saint Mary Mina be with us all. Amen. Also, on this day of the year 1684 of the martyrs, or 1968 AD, during the time of Pope Corollus VI, the 116th on the See of St. Mark, the Church received the relics of St. Mark the Apostle from Pope Paul VI, the Pope of Rome. A delegation of bishops and Coptic Christians received the relics with an official document that certified that these were the true relics of St. Mark that were kept in Venice, Italy, from the 9th century until the 20th. May the blessings of St. Mark, the apostle, be with us, and glory be to God forever. Amen. us, our Lord Jesus Christ, our God, who set to sin on our disciples and holy apostles. Many prophets and righteous men have desired to see the things which you see and have not seen them, and to hear the things which you hear and have not heard them. But as for you, blessed are your eyes, for they see, and your ears, for they hear, that we may be worthy to hear and act according to your holy gospels, through the prayers of your saints.
Pray for the holy gospel.
Lord,
remember also our Master, those who have bidden us to remember them in our supplications and prayers, which we offer unto you, Lord our God. Those who have already fallen asleep, repose them. Those who are sick, heal them, for you are the life of us all, the salvation of us all, the hope of us all, the healing of us all, and the resurrection of us all.
Cite metavo vo theokos men to agio evangelio. Ten je vesne o chen vranim shesentenigom. Kyrie flogison en to kata met se un agio evangelie. Eyo to anachn osma. Stand up with the fear of God. Let us listen to the Holy Gospel. A chapter from the Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew. May his blessing
be with us
Ben Shoiso, Ben Noti, Open Sotir, Open Oro Tirin, Esos, Behresus, Pshirim, if noted on Hebe, Onosha, Eni, Be off of Noti, Be Shine, Intini, Nitiro, Amin. From the Psalms of our teacher David the prophet and king, may his blessings be with us all. Amen. For you, O God, have heard my prayers. You have given an inheritance to them that fear your name. So will I sing to your name forever and ever, that I may daily pray for my vows. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, our Lord God, Savior, King of us all, Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, to whom is glory forever and ever. Amen. Then one was brought to him who was demon-possessed, blind and mute, and he healed him, so that the blind and mute man both spoke and saw.
And all the multitudes were amazed and said, "Could this be the son of David?" But when the Pharisees heard it, they said, "This fellow does not cast out demons except by Beelzebub, the ruler of the demon." But Jesus knew their thoughts and said to them, "Every kingdom divided against itself is brought to desolation, and every city or house divided against itself will not stand. And if Satan casts out Satan, he is divided against himself. How then will his kingdom stand? And if I cast out demons by Beelzebub, by whom do your sons cast them out? Therefore they shall be your judges. But if I cast out demons by the Spirit of God, surely the kingdom of God has come upon you. Or else how can one enter a strong man's house and plunder his goods, unless he first binds the strong man, and then he will plunder his house? He who is not with me is against me, and he who does not gather with me scatters abroad. Therefore I say to you, every sin and blasphemy will be forgiven men, but the blasphemy against the Spirit will not be forgiven men. Anyone who speaks a word against the Son of Man, it will be forgiven him. But whoever speaks against the Holy Spirit, it will not be forgiven him. Either in this age or in the age to come, either make the tree good and its fruit good, or else make the tree bad and its fruit bad. For a tree is known by its fruit. Broad of vipers, how can you, being evil, speak good things? For out of the abundance of the heart the mouth speaks. A good man out of the good treasure of his heart brings forth good things, and an evil man out of the evil treasure brings forth evil things. But I say to you that for every idle word men may speak, they will give account of it in the day of judgment. For by your words you will be justified, and by your words you will be condemned." In the name of the Father, and Son, and Holy Spirit, one God, amen. Today is the third Sunday of the month of Ba'una, and the Gospel according to St. Matthew chapter 12 is telling us about the healing of that man who was demon-possessed, blind, and mute. And our Lord Jesus Christ healed him. So today I will talk with you about merciful deeds facing accusation. That sometimes we did some good work and then we found that the reply back to us was not appreciated what we have done. But when we look to the life of our Lord Jesus Christ, we find many times and in many locations in the Gospel is talking about the same, that he did good deeds to the people and nobody appreciated what he has done. And he feed the people on the mountain, and maybe many of them, they went to the time of the cross, and then they went and say, "Crucify, crucify him." So merciful deeds are beautiful deeds that are favored by God and have not only earthly rewards, but heavenly rewards as well. A merciful deed usually has a positive impact received graciously amongst people. However, many times the merciful deeds are faced with resistance, like what happened with our Jesus. Our Lord Jesus Christ made many good deeds to the people, and he found resistance against that what he has done. We may even find the merciful persecuted for their good deeds, and this is what as a Christians facing in the world. So we do some good works to our people and then we face persecution after. The message of our Lord Jesus Christ is a message of goodness and salvation for humanity. Our Lord Jesus Christ did many good deeds while he was on earth, so much that St. Peter summarized Christ's service in the following statement: how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and with power, who went about doing good and healing all who were oppressed the devil, for God was with him. So they brought to our Lord Jesus Christ a man who was blind and he cannot see. And before they mention about this gospel, about this miracle, our Lord Jesus Christ was in the synagogue teaching. When you read the gospel, and then when he walked out of the synagogue, they brought him this man, was blind, mute, and demon-possessed. And our Lord Jesus Christ healed this man. This man, particularly in this, it was a simple of a man for all nation. The nation, he was in the synagogue, walked out of the synagogue, found this. So this is symbolically like the nation of the world who possessed by devil. And they could hear or could see. And the same for the people inside the synagogue, the Jews, he was with them. So those people in the synagogue could not listen to him, could not see him. So why the gospel mentioned that this guy brought him up right after when he walked out of the synagogue? Because it was symbolically like any one of us inside the church, but we cannot see Christ. Inside the church and we cannot listen to him. Inside the church and we cannot accept him. The demon possessed the people. So they not physically possessed, but also possessed by taking their mind and heart away from the church. That's why this symbolically, the miracle right happened after Jesus, our Lord Jesus was in the synagogue teaching, and then they found this man. But when our Lord Jesus Christ brought to him demon possessed and he healed him, that the mute and blind man was spoke and saw, the multitude were amazed and said, could this be the son of David? And what happened right after? They were almost to believe in him. But the people around started to change the ideas. They said, no, the Pharisees said, heard it, they said, they follow does not cast out demons except by Beelzebub, the ruler of the demons. So the people were almost to believe in him. Like, you know what? Sometimes I have intention to do some good. And then the people around me say, okay, postpone it. Don't do it now. Or there is no reward for this. Why you come early to the church? Why you do this good merciful? Why you waste your time? Why you waste your, you are wasting your money? Why you do that? Why you travel a long journey to serve the people whom you do not know? So you started your mind and your heart be changed to the people around you. That's exactly happened on today's miracle. The today's miracle, the people were almost to believe in him. They said, could this be the son of David? And the Pharisees came and they changed their mind and their heart. Also, when our Lord Jesus Christ healed the man with withered hand, the Bible says about scribes and Pharisees, but they were filled with rage and discussed with one another what they might to do Jesus. When our Lord Jesus Christ healed a woman who had an infirmity for 18 years and was bent over and could not raise herself up, Bible said, the ruler of the synagogue answered, there are 6 days in which men ought to work. Therefore, come and be healed on them and not on the Sabbath day. The Lord then answered him and said, hypocrite, does not each one of you on the Sabbath loose his ox or donkey from the stall and lead it away to water it? So ought not this woman, being a daughter of Abraham, whom Satan has bound, sing of it, for 18 years, be loosed from this bond on the Sabbath? And when he said these things, all his adversaries were put to shame, and all the multitude rejoiced for all glorious things that were done by him. So this woman was sick. And for 18 years, and when our Lord Jesus Christ, and then they started to accuse him for this miracle. Also, when our Lord Jesus Christ healed the man born blind, the same we find happened, the Pharisees started to say to them, the blind man and his parents accused Jesus. This man is not from God. When you find the acts of God inside your heart, inside your life, and then someone came, no, this is not from God. And the same happened in this story of the blind man. The people around him, the Pharisees came and said, this man is not from God. But how could he open the blind eyes? He let him to see. How this happened to him? So, and when the man who was born blind defended Jesus Christ, the Pharisees became angry with him and said to him, you were completely born in sins and you teaching us. And they cast him out of the synagogue. And after our Lord Jesus Christ raised Lazarus from the dead, and this miracle had a great effect to extend that many of the Jews who were present and saw this miracle believed in Christ. See what happened after this miracle. It says that then the chief priests and Pharisees gathered a council and said, what shall we do? For this man works many signs. They know that he worked with many signs. If we let him alone like this, everyone will believe in him. And the Romans, they give a reason why they are accused. They give a reason. And the Romans will come and take away both our place and nation. And decided at the end on killing Christ. And not only that, it says also they were intent to kill Lazarus himself just to cover their sin. That again is what our Lord Jesus made. Then from that day, they plotted to put him on death. That's why the church celebrated the Lazarus Saturday right before the Palm Sunday and the Holy Passion Week. So we celebrate Lazarus Saturday because he was a symbol of raising our Lord Jesus Christ. And he was accused and he was an innocent person. They accused him and put him to death also. Even if we look to our father, the apostle carried the message of their teacher, our Lord Jesus Christ, in doing good deeds, but also endured suffering for the sake of doing good. They healed, they entered, they opened cities, they opened countries, and they entered and preached Christ and healed the people. And the people, they got, they got arrested, and they let him into prison and killed them also. When St. Peter and St. John went up to the temple, they found a man who had been lame since birth. And he was carried to the gate of the temple to beg for charity. And when the man asked the saints for alms, St. Peter told him, silver and gold I do not have, but what I do have I give you. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, rise up and walk. And he took him up, and immediately his feet and ankle bones received strength. So he leaping up stood and walked and entered the temple with them, walking, leaping, and praising God. What was the reaction? What happened? They saw this guy standing beside the gate. Every day they enter the temple. Every day they enter. And then all of a sudden they want him leaping, walking in the temple. It should be a rejoice and happiness for this healing of this person. But the reaction was totally different. The book of Acts says, now as they spoke to the people, the priests, the captain of the temple, and the Sadducees, and they laid hands on them and put them in the custody until the next day. This is the reaction of doing good and merciful deeds. Why do good deeds face resistance? even with us, when you do sometimes a good something, this is we facing many every day maybe. And many people, they come to us and say, we did a good toward this guy, and then he returned evil this to us. Or even he or she is not appreciated what we did for them. Or he or she went out and spoke differently what we have done with them. So the question now, why do good deeds face resistance? Our Lord Jesus Christ as a simple for us. I give you all these examples that to put this and examples in front of us. When somebody does something bad or evil to us and you did good to him, remember all this. That our Lord Jesus Christ also, the first point is, he did the same and he was accused by those people he made good deeds to them. Our Lord Jesus Christ went about doing good, but it was never met with thankfulness and appreciation by the people. Instead, many resisted the good deeds and accused Christ with false accusation. It's not only ignored what he has done for them, but also to brought up accusation and false accusation against him. Those who do not like to good, not every man likes to do good deeds. Evil people hate goodness. They hate, and then it comes from the spirit of devil. When he drove up the demons out of this man, the devil could not keep silent for that. He started to go around, put inside the heart of the people to accuse this man. He came to destroy the kingdom of Satan and devil. So evil people hate goodness, so they resist good works and persecute those who do good. Goodness uncovers evil, and those who like evil oppress the benevolent. So this, the evil himself, the devil himself, does not bear this. So he started to make accusations because he wants everybody to be against everyone, each one against each one. He doesn't bear that he see people living in peace or do merciful works against each other. The chief priests and the Pharisees did not like to do good, but their life was an evil life filled with hypocrisy. And our Lord Jesus Christ revealed the evil in their life according to the Gospel of St. Matthew chapter 23. That's why they resisted Christ and did not rejoice in the good works he has done for them. So, what did they care about? The Gospel of St. John said that the chief priests and the Pharisees gathered a council and said, what shall we do for this man? They did not realize the importance of believing in Christ and did not understand Christ's words to them on the meaning of real freedom. When he said to them, most assuredly I say to you, whoever commits sin is a slave of sin. And a slave does not abide in the house forever, but a son abides forever. Therefore, if the son makes you free, you shall be free indeed. When the sin controls a person, it blinds his eyes and mutes his ears from seeing and hearing the truth. That's why the Satan could not bear that man who was possessed by the devil to be speak and see Jesus Christ and to hear his voice. So they do not like goodness, but resist those who do good, because doing good requires purity of heart and repentance. And also sometimes the devil wants to show us that we are different. One of the saints, I think Saint Anthony, he said, one day will come that when the righteous people do good works and deeds, the other people, they said, they are mad. يعني لما واحد يعمل حاجة كويسة وكله ما بيعملش الحاجة كويسة يقوله ده مجنون. الأنبا أنطونيوس قال كده. يعني if someone does a good thing and the other people doesn't do with that, the other people started to say, he said that this is will be by end of the days. That from the sin, the most of the people, they will say this guy is mad. Because he is a righteous person and he's on right track. That's what St. Anthony said. So, also our Lord Jesus Christ wanted at that time to change the meaning of Sabbath for the Pharisees. And the word Sabbath means rest, and doing good deeds gives rest to the needy, like the woman with the infirmity and the man with the withered hand. This is why our Lord Jesus Christ said the Sabbath was made for man and not man for the Sabbath. And when Christ was asked if it is lawful to heal on Sabbath, he assured them that it's lawful to do good on the Sabbath and every day if someone is in need. Also in the gospel of today, our Lord Jesus said, he who is not with me is against me, and he who does not gather with me scatters. By this he meant that his work is one thing and the devil's work another. For the devil is the enemy of human well-being, St. John Chrysostom said that. It is proper for the devil to scatter to utter destruction and for Christ to gather to salvation. Hence, it is clear that one who is against the Lord cannot be with the Lord. So one who is not with me is against. So the will of the devil, what is it? It's against the will of God. And my will, what is it? Only good. So since I am not with the devil, I am against the devil. If I am not commit the sin, so I am against the devil. For even as good is not with evil, but always against evil, so too they are not with each other, but against each other. And their will and their work are at odds. So the devil speaks, for instance, if we say that the devil speaks of fornication, but I speak of purity. Thus he turns away the pure and gathers the fornication into that's something legal in the society. Like every day now we say everybody does this. Why I am not different? Yes, because you are different because you are Christian. You are against the world. He said, I am against the world. And if you are resist the world, you have to be against the world, against the devil. So if you want to gather with Christ, you have to live in purity. He teaches, the devil teaches discord among the people. I teach peace among the people. So I am resist what he is doing. So he gathers the fighting among the people and disturb it, and I, the like-minded and gentle among others. So every time you find that something is coming to you with different thoughts, it's from, if it is from the devil, so you have the Holy Spirit resist this against. So if the world teaches us something, it's different from what our faith, so I am, yes, the against the world. Saint Athanasius, when is defending the faith against Arius, they said to him, all the world against you, Athanasius. What was his answer? And I am against the world. They said to him, why don't you pass this word? You pass this verse of belief. He said, no, if I change my forefathers' belief, I will change it, the Christianity. And then they said that if there is no Athanasius, we could have been all of us Arians believers, because he could change our belief. But because he resists he resists the devil, he resists the evil thoughts in Arian, so he could change the world to him. So do not feel or do not got scared that the world against you. If you are alone against the world, God will not leave you. If you are alone, resist what the devil doing in the world, you are alone, but not alone, but God, he will support and strengthen you in your work. That's why I do not, that if I do not gather with him, but I scatter, he says, less, that he may signify more. If he who is not with me is against me, how much more will he who is against me, but not with me? He is not with me because he does not do the things that I do. He is against me because acts contrary to me. Since I build, if anyone does not help me, even if he does not destroy. So at least, if you cannot build up with Christ, do not destroy what he does. Like the Pharisees today in the miracles of this morning. If they do not build with him and support this guy, at least do not destroy what he has done. And sometimes as Christian, we could not do some good deeds and works, but at least do not destroy what others from the good works does. And glory be to God now and forever. Amen.
And the love. entered into the world through the envy of the devil. You have destroyed by the life-giving manifestation of your only begotten Son, our Lord God and Savior, Jesus Christ. You have filled the earth with heavenly peace by which the host of angels glorify you, saying, glory to God in the highest, peace on earth, goodwill toward men.
Pray for perfect peace, love, and the holy apostolic greeting.
Lord,
according to your good will, O God, fill our hearts with your peace. Cleanse us from all blemish, all guile, all hypocrisy, all craftiness and the remembrance of vice bearing death, and make us all worthy, our Master, to greet one another with a holy kiss, that without casting us into condemnation, we may partake of your immortal and heavenly gift, in Christ Jesus our Lord.
Offer up for offering.
Give thanks to the Lord.
It is meet and right.
Aksiyun kedikiyun, aksiyun kedikiyun, alisus ghar. Then Master, Lord God of truth, being before the ages and reigning forever, who dwells in the highest and looks upon the lowly, who has created the heaven, the earth, the sea, and all that is therein, the Father of our Lord God and Savior, Jesus Christ, by whom you have created all things visible and invisible, who is seated upon the throne of his glory, and who is worshipped by all the holy powers. Principalities, the authorities, the thrones, the dominions, and the powers. You are he around whom stand the cherubim full of eyes, and the seraphim with six wings, praising continuously, without ceasing, saying,
let us attend.
Holy indeed, O Lord, thou art God, who formed us, created us, and placed us in the paradise of joy. When we disobeyed your commandment by the deceit of the serpent, we fell from eternal life and were exiled from the paradise of joy. You have not abandoned us to the end, but have always visited us through your holy prophets, and in the last days you manifested yourself to us who were sitting in darkness and the shadow of death. Through your only begotten Son, our Lord God and Savior, Jesus Christ, of the Holy Spirit, and of the Holy Virgin Mary. And taught us the ways of salvation. He granted us the purse from on high through water and spirit. He made us unto himself an assembled people and sanctified us by your Holy Spirit. He loved his own who were in the world as a ransom in our behalf, gave himself up unto death which reigned over us, whereby we were bound and sold on account of our sins. He descended into Hades through the cross. He rose from the dead on the third day. He ascended into the heavens and sat at your right hand, O Father. He has appointed a day for recompense, in which he will appear to judge the world in righteousness and give each one according to his deeds. Have God in a nechri empineshti mestereion enteti mitevesevish esashgari tevevemo Chayb onchem pekosmos. Avichenoi ke jenev jesus o aben atacheni o wahen atsole bohem makarion. O hen reftan ho Av gosht epshoyet veharok ve'etiv ofin yotiv noti vayv nipen teon neven etav shepehmot afiz moerof Aferagi azinemo If finiatin ofenagios masitis oahen apostolos oahab evgo emos. Jechi omi volen chitfitiru vai garbi basoma eton avash egen thenonem hankamishen sati vepko evolenteni novi. Vai eret fe epa erev me vei.
Vai kefen omezi. Amen.
Likewise, also the cup after supper he mixed it with wine and water, and when he had given thanks,
Amen.
He blessed it,
Amen.
He sanctified it. Also to his own saintly disciples and holy apostles, saying, take, drink of it, all of you, for this is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many, to be given for the remission of sin. This do in remembrance of me. Of this bread and drink of this cup, you proclaim my death, confess my resurrection, and remember me till I come. Also commemorate his holy passion, his resurrection from the dead, his ascension into the heavens, his sitting at your right hand, O Father, and his second coming from the heavens, awesome and full of glory, we offer unto you your gifts from what is yours, for everything concerning everything and in everything.
Worship God in fear and trembling.
We praise you, we bless you, we serve you, we worship you.
Let us attend. Amen.
By Oikemen and the Ifen Somaf O Aventa. Given for the remission of sins and eternal life for those who partake of him.
Make us all worthy, our Master, to partake of your holies unto the purification of our souls, bodies, and spirit, that we may become one body and one spirit, and may have a share and inheritance with all the saints who have pleased you since the beginning. Remember, O Lord, the peace of your one only holy, Catholic and Apostolic Church.
Pray for the peace of the one holy Catholic Apostolic Orthodox Church of God.
Lord, have mercy. This
which you have acquired to yourself with the precious blood of your Christ, keep her in peace with all the Orthodox bishops who are in her. For most remember, O Lord, our blessed and honored Father, the Archbishop, our Patriarch, Pope of Atawadrus II, and his spiritual brethren, the Patriarch of Antioch, Mar Ignatius Ephraim II, and the Patriarch of Eritrea, Abuna Antonius, and his partner in the liturgy, our honored father, the Bishop Ambassador.
Pray for High Priest, Pope of Atawadros II, Pope and Patriarch and Archbishop of the great city of Alexandria, and his brethren, Apostolic Liturgy, the Patriarch of Antioch, Mark Ignatius Ephraim II, and the Patriarch of Eritrea, Abun Antonius, and his partner in the liturgy, our honored father, the Bishop Ambassador Pion, and for our Orthodox bishops.
Lord, have
and those who rightly handle the word of truth with him, grant them unto your holy church to shepherd your flock in peace. Remember, O Lord, the Orthodox Egomens, priests and deacons.
Deacons, subdeacons in the seven orders of the Church of God.
Lord, have mercy.
and all the servants and all who are in virginity and the purity of all your faithful people, remember, O Lord, to have mercy upon us all.
Have mercy upon us, O God, the Father, the mindful Christ.
Remember, O Lord, the salvation of this your holy place and every place and every monastery of our Orthodox fathers.
Pray for the salvation of the world and of this city of ours and of all cities, countries, and monasteries.
For heaven.
Those who dwell there in God's faith, graciously accord, O Lord, to bless the air of heaven, the fruits of the earth, the waters of the river, the seeds, the herbs, and the plants of the field. This year.
The rising of the waters of the rivers, the seeds, the herbs, and the plants of the field, that Christ our God may bless them, have compassion on his creation, which his hands have made, and forgive us our sins.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
Raise them to their measure according to your grace. Give joy to the face of the earth. May its furrows be abundantly watered and its fruits be plentiful. Prepare it for sowing and harvesting. Manage our life as deemed fit. Bless the crown of the year with your goodness. For the sake of the poor of your people, the widow, the orphan, the traveler, the stranger, and for the sake of all of us who entreat you and seek your holy name, for the eyes of everyone wait upon you, for you give them their food in due season. Deal with us according to your goodness, O you who give food to all flesh. Fill our hearts with joy and gladness, that we, to having sufficiency in everything, always may abound in every good deed. Remember, O Lord, those who have brought to you these gifts, those on whose behalf they have been brought, and those by whom they have been brought. Give them all the heavenly reward.
Pray for these holy and precious gifts, our sacrifices, and those who bring them.
Lord, have mercy.
As this, O Lord, is the command of your only begotten Son that we share in the commemoration of your saints, graciously accord, O Lord, to remember all the saints who have pleased you since the beginning, our holy fathers, the patriarchs, the prophets, the apostles, the preachers, the evangelists, the martyrs, the confessors, and all the spirits of the righteous perfected in the faith. In o this with me in o to impartinus in se univin theotokos is o web dia St. John the Forerunner, Baptist and Martyr, St. Stephen, our Deacon and Proto-Martyr, the Beholder of God, the Evangelist Mark, the Holy Apostle and Martyr, the Patriarch St. Severus, our Teacher, Dioscoros, St. Athanasius, the Apostolic St. Peter, the Holy Martyr and High Priest, St. John Chrysostom, St. Theodosius, St. Theophilus, St. Demetrius, St. Cyril, St. Basil, St. Gregory the Theologian, St. Gregory the Wonder Worker, St. Gregory the Armenian, the 318 assembled at Nicaea, the 150 at Constantinople, and 200 at Ephesus, our righteous father, the great Ava Anthony, our righteous father, the three saints of Macedonia, and all their children, the cross-bearers, our father, John Nehegomin, a righteous father of Abishui, the perfect man, the beloved of our good Savior, our father of Palaptomony, Ezekiel, his disciple, my lords, the Roman fathers, saints Maximus and Domerius, the 49 martyrs, the elders of Shehit, the strong saint of Moses, John Cami, the priest, our father of Daniel, the Hegumen, our father of Isidore, the priest, our father of Bachum of the Kononia, and Theodore, his disciple, our father of Ashenuti, the Archimen, right, and of Awesa, his disciple, name Ebchurostir. In tenieth oav in tan naete volite noteu nem notov henainantiro eftop owo matogomed bepekranet oav and of moti emof ehri.
And Patriarchis et Avincot, Epshois Mantono and Epsikitiro, Avanter Caninovi, Nane.
Yeah.
Graciously, O Lord, repose the souls of your servants, Fued Yusuf, Amira Yusuf, Nadia Yusuf, the Lord, whose souls you have taken, repose them in the paradise of joy, in the region of the living forever in the heavenly Jerusalem, in that place. And we too who are sojourners in this place, keep us in your faith and grant us your peace unto the end. In this also in all things your great and holy name may be glorified, blessed and exalted in everything, honored and blessed with Jesus Christ your beloved Son and the Holy Spirit, be with all.
Again, let us give thanks to God the Pantocrator, the Father of our Lord God and Savior Jesus Christ, for he also has made us worth now to stand in this holy place, to lift up our hands and serve his holy name. Let us also ask him to make us worthy of the communion and partaking of his divine hand. Immortal mysteries.
Amen.
Beso maeso. Nem bi es nof etayot. Ente be Christos en jepi pantokrator, epshoi se penoti. Irini passi. You are the Logos of the Father, God before the ages, and the great High Priest, who was incarnate and was made man for the salvation of mankind. out of all the nations, he called to himself a chosen race, a kingdom, a priesthood, a holy nation, and justify it, people. Having sent the Holy Spirit upon the apostles in the day of the Pentecost, he came upon each one of them like divided tongues of fire and filled them with all knowledge, all understanding, and all spiritual wisdom, according to your faithful promise. And they spoke in every language, and they proclaimed your holy name to all the nations. As for Peter and Paul, the apostles, the shadow of the one was healing the sick, whereas the handkerchiefs and aprons of the other were causing diseases to leave and evil spirits to come away. And after they preached the gospel of the kingdom and taught the nations, they shed their blood for your name's sake and received the crown of apostleship and of martyrdom. O you who granted his holy disciples and honored the apostles, the descent of the Spirit, the paraclete upon them, and gave them authority to work healings, signs, and wonders, they proclaimed to us the glad tidings of his holy name and restored us to the true faith of the Holy Trinity. We praise you, we bless you, we glorify you, and we give thanks to you on account of these great gifts. And we ask you, our Master, to also grant us the forgiveness of our sins and to purify our hearts, our souls, bodies, and spirits, so that with a pure heart, we may dare with boldness without fear to cry out to your Holy Father who is in the heavens and say, Our Father who art in heavens.
Hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom comes, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one. Through Christ Jesus our Lord.
The power and the glory before you.
Vasi. Remember, O Lord, our assemblies, bless them.
Save them with your spirit in the fear of God. Let us attend.
Amen, Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
Tagiet is, hagis flogitos, kirios is of Christo to Ioto Theo, agiasmus ebnevma, agion amin. Soma gion keimeti mion elisinon eiso Christo to io to Theo emohon amin. Agion timion soma keima elisinon eiso Christo to io to Theo Emohon Amin. Besoman in Piesnov, ente Emmanuel Benoti, fai bechen omes mi amin. Amen, amen, amen. I believe, and confess to the last breath that this is the life-giving flesh that your only begotten Son, our Lord God and Savior, Jesus Christ, took from Our Lady, the Lady of us all, the Holy Theotokos, Saint Mary. He made it one with His divinity without mingling, without confusion, and without alteration. He confessed the good confession before Pontius Pilate. He gave it up for us upon the holy wood of the cross of His own will for us all. Truly I believe that His divinity parted not from His humanity for a single moment nor a twinkling of an eye. Given for us for salvation, remission of sins and eternal life to those who partake of Him. I believe that this is true. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. I believe. I believe that this is so in truth. Amen. Pray for us and for all Christians said to us concerning them. Remember us in the house of the Lord, the peace and love of Jesus Christ be with you. Sing Alleluia, pray for the worthy communion of the Immaculate Heavenly and Holy Mystery. Lord have mercy.